God our wisdom and strength. He has counsel and understanding. If he tears down, no one can rebuild. If he shuts someone in, no one can open up. If he withholds the waters, they dry up. If he sends them out, they overwhelm the land. We heard a beautiful reading from the book of Job. The book of Job focuses on the purpose of the life of every human being. If we speak about the purpose of our life, we may find it difficult to answer this. But when we speak about ourselves, our plans, or our projects, we find it easy to explain it. This is because when we speak about ourselves and our plans, we focus on ourselves. But when we have to speak about the purpose of our life, we have to look beyond ourselves. We have to look outside of ourselves. In order to speak about the purpose of life, we have to look at God. Because it is God who has designed our life. He is the author of life and He directs our life. Therefore, in order to know the purpose and meaning of life, we have to look at God. Therefore, the book of Job says, in the hands of God is the life of every human being. In the hands of God is the breath of every living being. So God directs the life of every human being. Therefore, when we look at God and when we go to God, we understand what our life is and how we have to live it. In the letter to the Ephesians, St. Paul beautifully explains how we can understand the purpose of our life. He says, we are created in Christ and for Christ. Therefore, we have this privilege of becoming the children of God. And this privilege comes to us because Jesus is our Savior. It is Jesus Christ who is the central aspect of our life, and we can find the meaning of our life in Jesus Christ. Therefore, dear brother and dear sister, let us go to Jesus, to our Savior and our Lord, and let us experience His living presence in us, so that we are able to understand the purpose of our life and we are able to know the real meaning.